Ho, ho, ho. Welcome, CHS, to the 13th edition of KCBY. I'm Santa Claus.
And I'm Mrs. Claus. On this week's holiday edition, we'll take a look at the winter wonderland of Coppell, Texas, and their holiday lights.
KCBY starts now. This past Tuesday, two Lee Elementary students got the surprise of a lifetime. Their father, after serving 5 months in Korea, came home for the holidays and surprised them at their lunch. KCBY was there to capture the surprise.
Yes, I've been gone since the 27th of July this year. I'm still in Korea. I'll be going back here in about another month. We've been planning this for probably about a month and some change now.
String up the lights and cue the music. These Coppell homeovers are decked out with Christmas lights more elaborate than ever. Ashley and Stephanie lit up the scene.
Coppell homeowner Brett Harrell has been putting on an extravagant light show since 2006. The unique feature about this setup is the self-created radio station synced to the lights.
I got the idea for the light show because of an internet video that went around in about 2006. Where someone had animated Christmas lights on their house, and it was even on a TV commercial. And so I went on the internet and I found a website that sold the controller boxes to make it all happen, and I set up a small display in the yard. And every couple of years since, I've added a little bit more to the light display. I've added more controller boxes and more lights and made it bigger. So the way the light show works is with a laptop, and it plays an audio file and it controls the lights at the same time. And I take the output of the laptop, the audio, and it feeds into speakers in the yard, and it also feeds into an FM transmitter. And that way people can tune in their car and listen to the music without being outside.
Megan Taylor, neighbor of Brett, is able to enjoy the light show by stepping right outside her front door.
What I really like about the light show is how the lights are synced to the music, because most houses don't do that. As it gets closer to Christmas, more and more cars come, and there's usually about eight to 10 cars a night. And it's really fun because you see little kids outside and they're like dancing to the music. What I like about it is I can literally just go outside and there's a light show for me. I don't really have to go to Grapevine or Addison. It's just right there in front of my house, and it's really fun just to walk outside.
My wife really enjoys it, and she gets into it and helps me with the display. My kids enjoy watching the music, and they enjoy the end product. They don't help too much with the setup, but maybe as they get older, they'll be able to help a little more. There's really two main purposes for our light show. One of them is that we collect toys, and we donate those toys to Children's Medical Center of Dallas. And that's something we started doing several years ago, and that's a neat opportunity for us to impact some children's lives and do a little bit of good in the community. And the other reason that we do it is to share our faith with other people and express the joy that we have through Jesus' birth at Christmas.
For KCBY, I'm Ashley Williams.
Sometimes, before you start the day, all you need is a fresh, local cup of coffee or tea and a healthy breakfast to change your entire outlook. It can boost your performance on almost everything you do. And here's the good news. Zenzero Bakery is less than a minute away from campus, where you'll find homemade pastries, pies, coffee, tea, and free Wi-Fi. Stop by and taste quality you won't forget. Zenzero, on the corner of Denton Tap and Town Center.
Last week, Cottonwood Creek Elementary students came to CHS to write their letters to Santa. The CHS English students assisted the learners in writing to Santa Claus. Ashley, Stephanie, and Kelsey jingled all the way to the action.
I think it's a neat way to collaborate and have the high school helpers, that's what we call them, help the younger students. They love to write and Santa, so it's a great way to write the letters and have some help and work together. I love watching it. They're always very enthusiastic and always really ready to help, which is great because it helps me as well. We're learning how to write, so it helps them work on their skills and work together.
We got a chance to talk to one of the kindergartners that wrote a letter to Santa.
I wanted a boat that has black Legos, and it has Legos, and there's brown, there's blue to brown to black. I was so excited to see it inside the high school.
This is just something fun for them to do. It's a nice break from all of the grueling stress of high school. And they just really are so happy. It really brings them out of their shell a little bit, and they get to have a little bit of fun and be silly with the kids and all that kind of thing. So it's awesome.
For KCBY, I'm Kelsey Neal.
Many of us have had Mr. Moore as a substitute teacher here at Coppell High School, but few of us know about his past experiences as a businessman. Blake, Sam, and Jared were able to sit down with Mr. Moore to learn more about his past endeavors and to see why he substitutes at CHS.
Well, I think the normal answer would be to occupy my time now that I am retired. But truthfully, it's for self-esteem. For many, many years, I was president and CEO of 250 steakhouses in California, and I was very successful. And after I retired, we sold our company. I formed my own company, More Ideas Incorporated, and I was a consultant and professional speaker. And so my self-esteem was satisfied there.
I think Mr. Moore brings a welcomed, real-world perspective to the classroom. Mr. Moore has a wealth of experience, life experience in business. He is concerned about the students. He's also concerned to hold them accountable. He has influenced students as that he has taken great interest in sports here. But I genuinely like him as a person. He's a fine human being, and I am very glad that he's here.
After I'd speak, people would come up and say, oh, you're great, you're wonderful, do you have a book? I thought, well, to be a good speaker, I have to have a book. And so I really wrote about experiences, about the myths of leadership. I substitute in Coppell because I'm appreciated by the teachers. The teachers ask for me, request me. But more importantly, I think the kids like me, and I love them. And so that really is, that's keeping me young. So it's very exciting to me and very impactful in my life.
And now to sports with Nick the Elf.
Thanks, Anna. I'm Nick the Elf. Welcome to CSBN. Last Friday night, the Cowgirls played off against John Paul II, a private school from Plano. KCBY was there to check out the action.
The Cowgirls played hard defense, trying to stop the Cardinals from getting their shots. But sometimes it wasn't enough to stop them. When the Cowgirls got back on offense, we played well, making some great shots. The Cowgirls fought long and hard, but it wasn't enough to beat John Paul II in the game. The final score was 48-41. For KCBY, I'm Megan McAdams.
The Cowboys also played off against the Grapevine Mustangs last Tuesday night at home in hopes of adding a win to their 4-8 record. KCBY was there to bring you the highlights.
With Grapevine's ability to play as a team, along with good accuracy and a quick gameplay, they dominated the Cowboys in the first half with a score of 29-19. The Cowboys began to show glimpses of a comeback in the second half with big plays by Andrew Herubin and Sam Marshall, but botched plays and missed shots hindered them, leaving the Mustangs to win 66-50. For KCBY, I'm Nick Wilson.
Three Coppell freshmen made it onto the varsity girls soccer team. Emily and Caroline sat down with these girls to see what it takes to play on the higher level.
After 12 years of playing soccer, Tyler Reynolds, Italia Bradley, and Mackenzie McFarland are ready to start their freshman year strong on the varsity team. They told us how they feel playing at this higher level.
It's definitely a challenge because like all the girls are really good and strong and big, but it's also fun because you get to meet new people. They're really cool.
We play outside of school on this higher level called BCNL, and we have college coaches coming and watching our games all the time, so we're really prepared for the pressure. So I think it's a great experience playing with older girls and meeting new people and learning new things, and you're really growing as a player.
Some people believe that freshmen do not deserve to be on varsity because they haven't earned their spot. We talked to the girls to get their opinion on this.
I think if you're good enough, it's based off of talent, so if you're good enough, I think it's fair enough that you should be there.
I feel that if you work hard for your sport and you're good at it, you can be on any level you want. It's your choice.
It's a lot of pressure, but I think I can handle it, so I'm really excited about it.
For KCBY, I'm Caroline Yeager.
Since the exciting 2014 football season has come to an end, many varsity players have won awards for the 7-6A district. Autumn, Jessica, and Abby sat down with these players to talk about their achievements.
Coppell seniors Charles West, Parker Wilson, Glenn Williams, Connor Williams, Jordan Murray, Tyler Hopkins, and Jacob Murray have been given awards for the 2014 season. These awards include MVP Offensive Player of the Year in both first offensive and defensive teams.
Well, anytime you've got a player that wins an award, especially a district award, you're always excited for that kid, and it's just it's a great accomplishment for them, and it says a lot about his teammates too. So really, really excited for those kids when they get rewarded by their other fellow coaches in the area.
Parker Wilson, who was unanimously voted to be the fullback on the first offensive team, told us what he thought about this achievement.
It feels really good, especially knowing the tough district that we were in and all the great players that also won the awards. To be recognized amongst them is a good accomplishment.
It's an awesome honor to have the MVP of the offense in this big district walk in your hallways, and those other kids can look up to him and see the time and effort that he put into it, and hopefully strive to achieve the same goals.
For KCBY, I'm Abby Foster.
Now back to Mr. and Mrs. Claus.
Thank you, Nicholas. And now to special features.
Hi, I'm here at Bass Pro Shop. We're gonna have a punny time today. It's gonna rock.
What did the buffalo say to his child?
Bye, son. I would consider him one of my dearest friends.
What did I want to be?
Look at that foxy lady. Every time I come to Bass Pro Shop, it's fun at first, but eventually it becomes a little bit of a bore. I saw one of my freshman friends here. Do you want to meet him? I can barely stand some of these punts. Now that's using your head. Just leave me alone already. See you later, alligator. That deal really reeled me in. I'll be going pro one day. Wow, the service here is sweet. That's already a pun. Would you believe my luck? I just found a buck on the ground. Wow, some of these puns are to die for. Okay, sorry, that was a bit of a stretch. Bass Pro is nothing like Target. I just found my favorite game here at Bass Pro Shop. It's called Flappy Bird. Well, I'm checking out.
Merry Christmas. Happy holiday.
Watching this wintry edition of KCBY.
Have a safe and wintry holiday break, CHS.
Oh, oh, oh.